Hello, Year One, and welcome to your first art lesson about painting. These are our lesson objectives for today. We need to be able to form a secondary colour by mixing two primary colours. By the end of the lesson, you'll be able to say what the primary colours are. You can mix two primary colours together, and you can say what secondary colour is made from mixing two primary colours. Let's look at some vocabulary that we're going to meet in this first session. There are some words here that we should already know. We know the word paint, paper, and colour. These are the words that we're going to meet along the way today. Primary, secondary, colour wheel, abstract, and Pierre Mondrian. In our knowledge organiser, we have got all of these elements. Now today, we are going to be focusing on colour. These are the building blocks that allow us to create works of art. Okay, we're looking at colour today. We're looking at primary and secondary colours. Let's find out what they are. Primary colours are the first colours we have. They are the start of other colours. And here we've got a picture of the primary colours. Our primary colours are red, blue, and yellow. Secondary colours. Secondary colours are what we get when we mix two primary colours. We're going to look at the artwork on the next slide, and I want you to have a think. How many of each primary colour do you see in Mondrian's work? Have a look at it here. While you're looking at it, think about these questions. What colours can you see? Which are primary colours? What do you notice about the shapes used? And where are the largest shapes? And why do you think this is? This is a piece of art created by an artist called Pierre Mondrian, and he has used primary colours to help us focus on different parts of his painting. He's used different size shapes to help draw our eye into different elements of his painting. We're going to learn a little bit more about Pierre Mondrian today. So let's find out a little bit more about him.
Pieter Cornelis Mondrian is born in Amersfoort, the Netherlands, in 1872. He studies to become an art teacher and later attends art college to learn how to paint. He starts with delicate landscapes, but under the influence of Van Gogh, our hero goes out at night to capture more stylized images and to dance. Over time, his work becomes more abstract. Piet is no longer interested in depicting reality, but the essence behind it. His painting style goes back to basics, horizontals and verticals in primary colors. A painting doesn't need to represent anything. It has to make you feel something. In the aftermath of the First World War, the style of neoplasticism, a Dutch artistic movement, picks up. Mondrian joins the movement from his Paris studio, where he covers the walls in colored cardboard to experiment with colors and dimensions. In 1940, he moves to New York, but shortly after completing Victory Boogie Woogie, he dies of pneumonia, aged 71. His influence on art can be found everywhere to this day.
Wow. That's a lot of information all about Pierre Mondrian. And here he is now. Pierre Mondrian was a Dutch artist, best known for his abstract paintings. Art that is abstract does not show things that are recognisable, such as people, objects, or landscapes. Instead, artists use colours, shapes, and textures to achieve their effect. Mondrian lived from 1872 to 1944. When Mondrian made his paintings, he would always mix his own colours, never using the paint directly out of a tube. He often used primary colours, red, yellow, and blue, as in this painting here. Mondrian loved to dance. He was especially good at dances called the waltz and the tango. Here, I've got an artist called Alfred. Now, Alfred needs your help today. Alfred the artist is trying to finish his masterpiece inspired by Pierre Mondrian. However, he has a problem. Alfred only has primary coloured paints. I wonder if you can pause the video here and answer this question. Which colour paints does Alfred the artist have? That's right, year one. Alfred has red, yellow, and blue paints. Alfred wants to make more colours for his masterpiece by mixing two primary colours at a time to make a secondary colour. Which colours will Alfred make when he mixes each pairs of colours? Pause the video here and see if you can answer the question. Let's have a look at this video and see if we can find out more about primary colours.
Oh, there are three primary colours. Only three are primary, it's true. The world is full of every kind of colour. But we're just talking red, yellow and blue.
Wow, children. So there are lots of different colours that you can make just from using our primary colours. Now, your activity today is to have a go at making some of these secondary colours. Now, we're going to do this on Purple Mash, but if you have some paint at home, maybe you can try this out at home too. So here's your job for today. Can you use an object, a paintbrush, maybe a finger, and dip it into your paint? Can you mix your paint yourself? And can you create your own secondary colours? Have a look at them when you've mixed them. What colours can you make? Can you make the same as the ones on the screen? Okay. Let's test our knowledge to see if we've learned, see what we have learned from this lesson. True or false, children? Question one, Red and blue makes orange. Question two. Blue and yellow makes green. In question three, violet is a secondary colour. Well done, children, for sorting out your primary and your secondary colours and for learning a little bit more about Pierre Mondrian.